Hello friends, welcome back to our tutorial, Designing an Impressive Architectural Building in Revit 2018 Imperial.
If you have been following along, go and open the file 00_022_DIABI_I where you save it. You can also download this file from the website. Go and click the File tab, hover the mouse cursor to save as and select Project. This will bring the Save Drawing as the Save As dialog box. Rename this file to 00_023_DIABI_I and click the Save button. In the last tutorial, we designed the fascia for the roof. In this tutorial, we're going to design the soffit for the roof. Go to the project browser and click the plus sign next to the ceiling section if the ceiling category collapse and select the first floor plan. Zoom in into this area. Go to the architectural tab, building panel, and click the down arrow after the roof command and select the soffit command. This brings the roof soffit generic 4 inches, but the roof soffit generic 4 inches is too thick for our need. So click the edit type button, click duplicate, rename this to my generic 1/2 inch, and click OK. In the construction section, click the edit structure to change the structure of the ceiling. Change this figure to 1/2 inch. Click OK. Click OK to return to the drawing. We have something to correct in this area. Now click the pick line button and zoom in into this area. Pick this line, this edge of the fascia board. Zoom in and pick this short line where the two fascia board meet at the cable. Pick the edge of the wall and the edge of this wall. Go to the modify panel and select the trim extend to corner. Zoom in into this area, click this short sketch line and this line. Click this sketch line, this sketch line. Go to the floor plan section and double click the roof to open that view. Click the pick line button and click the valley of this roof. Select the trim extend to corner, select this sketch line and this sketch line, this sketch line and this sketch line. Go to the model panel and select the slope arrow. Start the slope arrow at the midpoint of this sketch line and draw it towards the sketch line on the right side. With this slope arrow still selected, go to the properties palette, click this down arrow and change to slope, and change the dimension to 6 to 12. Click the green check mark to close the figure. If you don't have a section in this area, go to the quick access toolbar and select the section command and draw a section to this area. I'm going to press escape. Right click the section and select go to view. Now this is the surface that we just created. Change the surface level to the roof level and change the offset to -1'6" and see the result. Click the X button to close this view and click the X button again to close the roof view in the floor plan. Back to the ceiling first floor plan. Go to the architectural tab, click the down arrow and select the soffit command. Make sure that my generic 1/2 inch soffit is selected. Click the pick line button, zoom in into this area. Pick this edge of this fascia board, the edge of this fascia board, the edge of this fascia board, the edge of this fascia board, and pick this small edge of the fascia board. Pick the wall, this wall, this wall, this wall. Go to the select the trim extend to corner, trim, 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 trim. Select the short line and trim it to this line. Trim, trim. go to the floor plan section in the project browser and double click the roof plan to activate it. Select the pick line button and click the value of this roof. Select the trim extend to corner. Select the sketch line, this sketch line, this sketch line, this sketch line. Click the slope arrow. Start a slope arrow from the midpoint of this line and draw the slope arrow to the sketch line to the left side of the to the left side. Click this down arrow and select slope. Click this input and type 6. Move the mouse away from the property palette. Change the offset height from level to minus 1'6". Move away from the property palette. Click the green check mark and change the level to roof level. Go to the 3D view to see the results. Hold down, go to the section area. Close the default 3D view. Select this section plan. Use the move tool to move this section plan away to this overhanging. And click the right click, go to view. Click on this section plan and select the move command. Pick at the end point of this surface and snap to this. Click out, go to the default 3D view to see the results. Select the surface, click the edit type. Because now the surface and the roof has the same color, you can't tell the difference. We're going to temporarily assign a color to this surface. Click the structural material tab. This brings the material browser. And click the color tab and select the this color, this first color. Click OK. Click OK. Click OK to see, to close the dialog box. Click out. Change the visual style to shaded and see the results. Go to the ceiling in the project browser. Go to the ceiling section and select the first floor plan. Now select this surface. Go to the modify panel and click the mirror pick axis. Pick this line of the surface to mirror it in the opposite side. Click the edit boundary and use the align command. Zoom in into this area, click the edge of this fisher board and align this sketch line to that fisher board. Click the edge of this wall and align the sketch line. Zoom in into this area, click the edge of this edge where the two fisher board meet at the cable and align this line. Go to the modify panel and select the trim extend to corner. Select this sketch line, this sketch line. Click the modify button. Hover the mouse cursor to this sketch line, press the tab key. Click once, hit delete on your keyboard. Zoom out by rolling the mouse wheel upward to see the result. Click the green check mark. Go to the modify panel and select the mirror pick axis. Zoom in into this area and pick this axis. Click the edit boundary. Go to the floor plan section and double click the roof plan to open that view. Zoom in. Alright, the sketch is in the right place. Now click the green check mark. Close this view to return to the ceiling first floor plan. Hover the mouse cursor into the individual of the surface line. Press the tab key and click to select the surface. Click the mirror pick axis, zoom in into this area and pick the axis. Click the edit boundary and select the align command. Zoom in and pick the edge of this fisher board and pick this line. Select the trim extend to corner. Select this sketch line, Click the modify button. Hover the mouse cursor to this sketch line. Press the tab key. Click and hit delete on your keyboard. Select the slope line and select the move, use the move command. Click on this point, move the mouse cursor and snap to the midpoint of this sketch line. Click the green check mark. Click the mirror pick axis. in the floor plan, in the floor plan section in the project plans, I double click the roof plan, use the arrow the mouse cursor to any of these soffit objects and press the tab key. When you see the entire soffit in this area highlighted, click to select it. Zooming into this area, you see a mark where the two fisher board meet at the gable. Use a mirror pick axis and click on this line to mirror the soffit into the opposite side. Now click the edit boundary, go to the floor plan section and double click the roof plan. The soffit is in the right location. Click the green check mark. Close this view to go back to the first floor ceiling plan. Hover the mouse cursor into this soffit, press the tab key, press again until the entire soffit in this area highlighted. Click. Go to the modify panel and select the mirror pick axis. Pick this reference plane. Click the edit command. Go to the modify panel and select the align command. Zoom in into this area and I'll select the edge of this wall. Click this to align. Select the edge of the fisher board. Click to align. Select the trim extend to corner. Select this sketch line and this sketch line. Click on join. Press escape. Select this sketch line. Hit delete. This sketch line, hit delete. Select the slope arrow. Select the move command. Click from this point and snap to the midpoint of this line. Click on this bubble and drag it to the click on this circle and drag it to the midpoint of this sketch line. Select the move command again, snap and move this to the edge of this sketch line. Select the pick line button and snap to the edge of this soffit. Select the trim extend to corner, select this sketch line, press escape, select this line and hit delete on your keyboard. Go to the floor plan and double click the roof plan to open that view. Click OK to close the figure. Now click the modify button. Go to the properties palette and click the viewing to edit it. Change this figure to 30 feet and the cut plan to 20 feet. Click OK. Click the X button to close this roof plan view and return to the first floor plan, floor ceiling plan. Select the soffit, click the edit boundary. Go to the roof plan and make sure that the edge of the sketch line align with this edge. Click the green check mark. The soffit still selected. You can tell on the filter button. Click the mirror pick axis and pick the midpoint of this roof to mirror it to the opposite side. Go to the default 3D view to see the results. Now, let's go to the ceiling plan section, ground floor plan. Zoom in into the back of the model. Go to the architectural tab, building panel, click the down arrow next after the roof and select roof soffit. Click the pick line button. Pick the edge of this wall and the edge of this wall, the edge of this wall. Pick the edge of the fisher board, the edge of the fisher board. Then zoom in close to this area and click the edge where the two fisher board meet. Select the trim extend to corner. Select the short sketch line and trim it to this sketch line. Select this sketch line, trim it to this sketch line. Select this sketch line, trim it to this sketch line. Select this sketch line, trim it to this sketch line. Press escape. Click the slope arrow and start to the midpoint of this sketch line and move it the next point to the sketch line on the right. With the arrow still selected, go to the property palette, click the down arrow and select slope. Change this dimension to 3 to 12. Click the green check mark. Change the level to first floor plan. Go to the default 3D view to see the results. Hold down the Shift key and your middle mouse button to orbit. Click the X button to close this view. Zoom in into this area. Go to the quick access toolbar and select the section command. Zoom in around this area and draw a section from this point to this point. Click the flip arrow to flip it inside. Right click the section, go to view. Select the soffit and change the offset to -1.6. Move the mouse away from the property palette. Go to the ground floor ceiling plan, and with the soffit still selected, click the mirror pick axis. Click the edge of this soffit. Click the edit boundary button. Go to the first floor plan in the floor plan section. Select the pick line button and click the valley of this roof. Select the trim extend to corner. Select this sketch line and this sketch line. This sketch line and this sketch line. Click the modify button. Select the slope. Click select and select the move command. Pick from this endpoint and snap it to the midpoint of this sketch line. Click the green check mark. Revit complained because of this sketch line at the bottom of this area. So now I click continue, select this line and hit delete. Click clean the grid check mark. Go to the mirror pick axis and go to the modify panel and select the mirror pick axis. Click this value and click the edit boundary command. Select the align command. Click the edge of the fascia board and align the sketch line. Click the edge of this wall and align the sketch line. Click the edge of this wall and align this sketch line. Click the green check mark. Go to the default 3D view to see the result. Go to the first floor ceiling plan. Select this, the soffit object. And go to the modify panel, select the rotate command. Zoom, move the mouse cursor and click to this intersection. Now move away and make sure that to straight the ceiling. Select this and select the rotate command. Zoom into this area and click to this intersection. Now move and snap to this direction. Select this, rotate, snap to this intersection, move away, and click. Go to the quick access toolbar and click the default 3D view. Click the, hold down the shift key and your middle mouse button to orbit. Click on this vertex of the view cube. Click the X button to close all the hidden views. Click the save button in the quick access toolbar. Alright, in this tutorial we modeled the surface of our project. In the next tutorial we're going to model the ceiling of our project. If you like this tutorial, please click the like button and share it to your friend. If you have any question, please leave a comment below. If you want to continue this tutorial or any other tutorial on my channel, please subscribe. Thanks very much for watching. I hope to see you in the next class. Goodbye.